PrusaSlicer 2.3 is out. At least, by the time you're watching this video, it should be out. And it comes with new features like monotonic top infill, ironing, paint-on support material, and automatic variable infill patterns. Here's the thing though, PrusaSlicer and all the features it comes with are not exclusive to the original Prusa 3D printers. In fact, Prusa actually reached out and asked if they could sponsor this video where I show you how to set up the new PrusaSlicer for basically any 3D printer. It's free and open source software, so this is basically a free upgrade for the printer you already have. Let's get right into it. Step 1. Download and install PrusaSlicer from Prusa3D.com. You can get the stable versions right here, or if you want the absolutely newest unstable version, you can grab that straight from GitHub. Step 2. Run the configuration wizard. PrusaSlicer 2.3 is integrating a lot more ready-made community profiles, and chances are you're going to find a ready-to-go profile for maybe the exact printer you have, or one that is similar enough. For example, the Ender 3 profile is going to be a great starting point for the Ender 3 Pro 2, as well as the Ender 3 V2, as well as basically any other printer that is built like an Ender 3, which is almost all of them actually. Hit finish, and that's it! PrusaSlicer is now ready to use for your printer. Thanks for watching, happy holidays, and I'll... No, just kidding. I mean, this is a perfect option if your printer is already in there, but let's go through the custom printer option and the changes I usually make just to make my life a bit easier. Also, we're going to steal some profiles from the original Prusa machines. So, in the configuration wizard, which you can get to through the configuration menu, the first thing to do is to actually enable a profile for an original Prusa printer. For example, for the Mark 3S with a 0.4mm nozzle. We're going to need that later. Then, of course, the next step is in the custom printer menu. First, choose a printer name. Then, for the firmware, you're probably going to want to choose Marlin, but some printers, especially when they're running weird proprietary firmwares, might need RepRap's printer selected here in case they act up with the Marlin setting. Next, for bed shape and size, just plop in the usable print area for your machine. Then, in filaments and nozzle diameters, the default of 0.4mm for the nozzle and 1.75mm for filament are correct for 99.9% of printers out there. And then for temperatures, I like to go with a basic 210 degrees and 60 degrees Celsius for PLA. Now, this will create a new, very basic filament profile, but since I'm going to show you how to snatch profiles off of the Mark 3S, what you put in here doesn't matter all that much. For now, hit finish and you'll have new profiles for print settings, filament, and the printer itself. And you can totally use those or make tweaks off of them. For example, I would recommend reducing the layer height from the 0.3mm that comes set up as default, as well as tuning down speeds a bit as they're about 50% faster than what is usually considered like safe speeds to get good prints on most machines. But those adjustments won't get used when you use a different print or filament profile. However, the printer profile is one that we're gonna keep. So let's get this one dialed in first. First things first, switch to the expert view mode, which is going to show you all the settings available. Once we're done setting everything up, you can always switch back to basic or advanced mode to hide the settings you're not going to be using anyway. You don't have to and actually shouldn't mess with a lot of these settings, but here's the ones that are important. In the general tab, set the maximum print height to the height your printer can safely reach. Then in custom G-code, we're going to adjust the start and end G-code, that is the commands the printer always runs before and after the actual print. For the start G-code, first of all, if you have a bed probe on your printer, you can run an auto-leveling pass by adding a line with G29 right after G28, which is just homing. Then if you want the nozzle priming line that the printer does at the front edge of the bed before it starts the actual print, you're going to need to make sure everything is preheated before it tries to do that, and that the printer then runs the actual priming line. I'm also putting the full start and end G-code in the video description so that you can just copy and paste it. Now, for the end G-code, there are two things to add. First, for some reason, by default, it's missing the command to cool down the bed. That is M140 S0. And then if you want the printer to move the print bed forwards towards you when the print finishes, that's G1 Y200 F9001 for a 200mm deep bed. If you have a moving bed on your printer, that is. Otherwise, this is just going to move the tool head back, which is fine too, I guess. Next, machine limits. My recommendation here is to change these to use for a time estimate, because otherwise some limits already set in your printer's firmware may get overwritten, which can cause some issues with reliability. Lastly, in Extruder 1, you'll find the fun setting, specifically for retraction. The default retraction length is 2 millimeters, but for a direct drive extruder, I'd recommend 1 millimeter or less. For a Bowden, you probably want around 4 millimeters. Enabling Lift Z with a lift height of 0.5 millimeter is also a good idea unless your printer's Z-axis is like super extra slow. But generally, this cuts down on stringing a bit, keeps the nozzle from knocking over the print, and doesn't really impact print time. It's kind of the same with wipe while retracting. Just check the box, it makes your prints a tiny bit nicer, and it doesn't harm anything. So about the other two components of the PrusaSlicer config, the tabs called Print Settings and Filament Settings. Like I said, the settings in here right now are usable, but PrusaSlicer comes with better profiles that by default are marked as only being compatible with the Prusa 3D printers. But we can actually tell PrusaSlicer something like, you know, the thing about these profiles being made for specific printers, they're not made for specific printers. Keep in mind though, that while filament profiles work pretty much universally, the print settings profiles could need a bit of adjustment depending on your exact printer setup. Generally though, they should be a bit more refined than the default profile that generates with a custom printer setup. So to grab a profile from the Mark 3S, let's start with the print settings. Make sure to have the Mark 3S selected as your current printer, as well as the profile you want to copy. Then go into the Print Settings tab, and all the way down at Dependencies, click Detach from System Preset. Then, yes, and pick a new name, something like 0.15 mm Quality Universal. Then make sure the new profile is selected, which it will be by default, and check all for compatible printers, and delete the line for compatibility conditions. Now, if you choose your custom printer again, you'll see that you can now use the copied profile for that machine as well. It's similar for filament settings. Again, make sure the Mark 3S is selected, then go to the filament profile you want to copy, click Detach, choose a new name, and then for the new profile, make sure both checkboxes are clicked to all and the text boxes are empty for the compatibility conditions. You should also check that in the custom G-code settings, both boxes are empty. These settings are specific to the Mark 3S in this case. And also for the filament override settings, these temporarily change some of the options in print settings when you have this one specific filament profile selected. It's a feature that can be very useful, but the settings in there right now are set up for a direct drive printer. So if you're using a Bowden printer or a printer where you think these overrides won't work, you should probably disable these. And there you go. You've got PrusaSlicer set up for your own printer with what I think is a really good universal set of print settings. Now again, these might still need some tuning for your specific printer. The one thing I like to do is to fatten up the first layer to make it less sensitive to bed leveling errors. You can do this in print settings by increasing the first layer height to about 3/4 of your nozzle size, so around 0.3 millimeters, and also by making the extrusion track wider in the advanced settings under extrusion width first layer. I found that 1 millimeter works great here. So what do you actually get now that you're set up with PrusaSlicer? Here's some of the features that I find super useful and that contribute to the fact that, you know, PrusaSlicer has become my personal go-to slicer. First, what you already saw, the separation of print settings and filament settings. So you can have your profiles for fast printing, printing with supports, vase mode, etc. And then an independent set of profiles for printing with PLA, PETG, ASA, wood fill, etc. without having to create a separate profile for every possible combination of a specific print setting and a filament. Then in the plater, the absolute best time saver is the lay flat tool. You can find it on the toolbar on the left here, and from there it's literally just a single click to rotate your part into the perfect orientation for printing. That is so much better than messing around with rotation handles, which you can still do, but why would you? What I also use is background processing, which you can enable in configuration preferences, which makes seeing what the different settings do a whole lot faster. By the time you click back to the plater tab, usually your part is already going to be sliced and ready with your new settings. And of course, there are the new options of using paint on support material, ironing, adaptive cubic infill, but covering all those in detail would be its own entire video. If you want to learn more about them, Prusa already has videos up covering the new features. In any case, if you create a profile that works really well for your specific printer, please do share it with people that could make use of it as well. You can export and import profiles directly from the file menu. Or, if you're a manufacturer, there's an official guide on how you can create your own config bundle that can then be included with the official PrusaSlicer releases. Thanks again to Prusa Research for sponsoring this video, and thank you to all my patrons for your continued support. Without you, I really couldn't be making these videos. 2020 has been a huge learning experience for me, and honestly, things can only get better in 2021. I would like to thank you all so much for watching. Like the video if you did, subscribe to see more like it. Keep on making, and I'll see you in the next year. Happy holidays. Stay safe, everyone.